treatment landscape in advanced renal cell carcinoma is rapidly changing and moving toward the IO combinations. In the past, multiple kinase inhibitors were able to improve the disease control, progression to survival, and overall survival. And more recently, IO-IO combinations and IO tyrosine kinase inhibitors combination are able to increase in a statistically relevant method, but also from a clinical point of view, the outcome for the patient. We have an improvement in median progression to survival, in overall survival, in objective response rate, and often patients may obtain the complete remission of the disease. But there are some issues. First one represented by several IO combinations, including two IO, a double IO combination, like nivo-plasip, nivolumab-plasip, nivolumab, or a combination between multiple kinase inhibitors and PD-1, PD-L1 inhibitors, like pembrolizumab plus axitinib, or nivolumab plus cabozantinib, or just this week will be presented the data of the CLEAR trial supporting the impressive role of pembro plus lenvatinib. And so we have several therapeutic options without a predictive biomarkers able to select the best treatment strategy. The question for physician and investigator is how to choose between different options. Physician may use all therapeutic options in first line without an agreement, of course. Complete remission could be a driver of choice, of course. Longer progression to survival, symptom relief. Or on the other hand, the activity of this combination is not the same according to some features of the population and the disease. For example, patients having low risk disease and a low magnitude of benefit in comparison with a patient having intermediate or poor risk disease. So we have to balance well according to the features of the patient of the disease, according to the guidelines, according to the recommendations. Of course, the future is less dark for our patients, but we have to work very, very so much to identify predictive biomarker and to select the best treatment for our patient, and also consider carefully the safety profile. The safety profile is a very, very important point, and we have to balance the safety profile with the compliance to maintain the best compliance for our patients.